Life, we need to worship the Lord. Amen. My message will be brief, it will be powerful. Amen. There will be miracles.
Amen.
But we have to worship this Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ye have given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shiny crown. Instead of ashes and glory in the place of His grace. Come on now. You have given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shiny crown. Instead of ashes and glory in the place of His grace. You have given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes, and glory in the place of His grace. Come on now! You have given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes, and glory in the place of His grace. Listen! I delighted greatly in you, my soul rejoices and sings. For you took my empty life and filled it with every good thing. You have given me the oil of gladness, the shine of praise. Instead of joy, the shining crown. Instead of ashes, and glory in the place of Israel. I delighted greatly in you, my soul rejoices and sings. For you took my empty life and filled it with every good thing. Come on up!
Ye have given me the oil of gladness, the crown of praise. Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes, a glory in the place of praise.
Come on up! When my life was without a purpose, you gave me a reason to live. Now my heart is full of thanksgiving for all the things you have given me. You have given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes, a glory in the place of His grace. Come on now. He has given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes, a glory in the place of His grace. One more time. He has given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes and glory in the place.
Louder, one more time, come on everybody.
He has given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise. Instead of mourning, the shining crown. Instead of ashes, the glory in the place of His grace.
Everybody.
He has given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise.
Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes, and glory. One more time.
He has given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes, and glory in the place of His grace. He has given me the oil of gladness, the garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes, and glory in the place of His grace.
Come on up!
He has given me the oil of gladness, a garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes, a glory in the place of His grace.
One more time!
He has given me the oil of gladness, a garment of praise. Instead of mourning, a shining crown. Instead of ashes, a glory in the place of His grace.
Hallelujah.
Sing it to yourself every morning. Sing it to yourself every morning. God has given me the garment of praise. Am I communicating here? He has given you the garment of praise. Hallelujah. 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 Your heart should be full of thanksgiving. Full of thanksgiving. Glory to God. Father, we thank you. Thank you for encouraging us today. Thank you for your word that is about to come. Thank you for your presence that is so strong in this place. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Shall we say big amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Take your Bibles quickly. Let's go to the Word of God tonight. I'll preach a message titled, Desperate for Change. Desperate for what?
Change.
Desperate for what?
Change.
Desperate for change. I want you to know that change is possible. And that when your life is going in the wrong direction, you don't like what you see, you can change it. I want to show you how faith, doesn't matter how you were born, what background you came from, how faith can change your story. The power of faith, believing, learning to trust the Lord, believing. When we release the spirit of faith, what can happen in us? Faith can change anything. You may not have so much money in your account right now. You may have been struggling for a long time, but faith can change your story. Faith can change your story. Mark chapter 10, verse 46 to verse 52. Mark chapter 10, verse 46 to verse 52. Desperate for change. Desperate for change. Mark 10, 46 to 52. If you are there, say I'm there. And I read, and they came to Jericho. And as he went out of Jericho with his disciples, and a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side begging. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And many charged him that he should hold his peace. But he cried the more, a great deal, the son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stood still and commanded him to be called. And they called the blind man, saying unto him, be of good comfort, rise, he calleth thee. And he, casting away his garment, rose and came to Jesus. And Jesus answered and said unto him, what wilt thou that I should do unto thee? The blind man said unto him, Lord, that I might receive my sight. And Jesus said unto him, go thy way, thy faith has made thee whole. And immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus in the way. Hallelujah. 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 Follow me quickly. This is the only place in scripture where the name of the person being healed by Jesus is mentioned. Bartimaeus has a double meaning. Bartimaeus is a name that has a double meaning. Now, when the Bible decides to mention the name of a person being healed by Jesus, it was not by accident. It was for a purpose. There's something about that name that God wants you to discover. God wants us to learn something from that name, Bartimaeus. He could have just said a blind man, but he said blind Bartimaeus. He didn't stop there. He went down to his lineage, to his root, and he said, the son of Timaeus. What is it about Bartimaeus and what is it about Timaeus that is so important that the Bible gave it emphasis? This name Bartimaeus has double meaning. One meaning is a Greek meaning, which means honorable man. Somebody say honorable. Shout it loud. Shout it again. Honorable man. That's a good name. There's nothing wrong with that. But he was an honorable man that was blind. If they had just stopped there, that would have been beautiful. His problems would have been highly, 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 highly minimized. But then the name has another meaning. The other meaning is a Hebrew meaning, which means hair or son of unclean. The first meaning is what? Honorable. The second meaning is what? Hair or son of unclean. Now, how can one man bear two names that don't resemble? One is honorable. The second one is son of unclean, or hair of unclean, which means by implication or implication of his name, his inheritance is unclean. Oh, you are not hearing me. Hair. What is a hair? A hair is someone who is entitled to inherit something. Am I correct? So when you say, when the Bible makes it clear to us, or when we get to discover that the meaning, one meaning of that name is hair or son of unclean, it means that this man, by reason, by implication, his inheritance is unclean. Now, as you stand up, I feel an anointing on me to prophesy. As you stand up to say 30 times amen, you will not inherit the devils of your father. Let me say that again. I said, you will not inherit your father's devils. Sit down. Bartimaeus, honorable. When Bartimaeus is going out, one person will call him, hey, Mr. Honorable. He will say, excuse me. Just as the man is finishing, another one would call him and say, ah, hair of unclean. That brings complication. It means that man has what we call complicated personality. In English, we call it duality. D-U-A-L-I-T-Y. Or, let's simplify it. a person with a double life. Duality. Today, they see one side of him that looks good. Tomorrow, they see the other side of him that looks evil. So when he wants to marry, who with the lady he's proposing to marry? Is it Mr. Honorable or Mr. Unclean? You see dilemma? Because when Mr. Honorable shows up and proposes to a lady, the lady will say, I accept. But then, no sooner she has accepted, Mr. Unclean will show up. And then the wife is confused. I thought I knew you when I married you. You have changed. Oh, I feel like running on this one now. Am I still communicating here? How many times have people said such things? I thought I knew this man when I married him. Oh, he wasn't like this. What happened to him? Mr. Honorable was what you saw when he proposed to you. After marriage, you saw Mr. Unclean. Oh God. Am I still communicating here? Mr. Honorable was what appeared. And you fell in love with Mr. Honorable. Then suddenly, Mr. Unclean showed up. And the Bible makes it clear that it is an inheritance from the many. That's why it stressed that word, the son of Timaeus. Oh God. Oh God. It's coming from somewhere. So, now, the Bible makes it clear, this boy or this man became blind. Honorable. Blind honorable. That means by potential, this man has the potential to be great in life. Am I still here? This man has the potential to be what? Great in life. But for whatever reason, something that is unclean is attached to him. He has, when you look at him head to toe, when you look at the way he does his things, when you look at him, he has the potential to be great in life, to be honorable. But for whatever reason, there is something, there's uncleanness that's attached to his destiny. And that unclean part of him has gained strength and has overpowered him to a point where he lost his sight. Now, even though he has great potentials, he's subjected to begging. He has to now wear the beggar's robe and stand by the highway side and be begging. He was not begging by choice. He was begging by force. Anything you are forced to do, stand on your feet, everybody. Anything you are forced to do that is contrary to the plan and the purpose of God for your life, whatever the force or the power that compels you to keep doing something that is contrary to your to God's destiny for you, God's plan and purpose for you, tonight the power of the Holy Ghost takes it away from you. 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 Lift your voice and shout a big amen. See that? Bartimaeus was not blind and begging by choice. He was blind and begging by force. How do I know? I will show it to you very shortly. He was not begging by choice. He was forced into it. He was forced into it. Blindness, his condition, subjected him to begging, humiliating his destiny. God did not call you to be humiliated in life. Christianity is not humiliation. Being born again is not humiliation. As I speak right now, from this day forward, you will never suffer humiliation again. Whatever has
has been humiliating your destiny, today the grace of God take it away from you. The hand of God take it away from you. The power of God take it away from you. The blood of Jesus take it away from you. Lift your voice and shout the controls, amen. Blind Bartimaeus, sit down. Mr. Honorable. Honorable, that is also Mr. Unclean. What is honorable about unclean? That is a dilemma. That is a big conflict. And when somebody has that kind of, find himself in that kind of situation, his personality takes on a very complex level. Complicated personality. Sometimes you see some people, they behave in a bizarre manner. You wonder, why are you like this? What is wrong with you? Why are you like this? What's wrong with you? But this guy was fighting it. He would not take it. He would not accept it. He was crying out for something. I'm not supposed to be like this. I'm not supposed to be like this. I'm not supposed to be like this. Blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus. He came from an unclean background. His background was unclean. Background matters in life. But thank God for Jesus. Am I communicating here? Background matters. And I know you have heard a lot of teachings on that in the past. Background matters. It matters clearly. My children did not have the same background that I had. They had a different background. My children have an elite background. Yes. Not the same background that I had. Their upbringing is so different. They grew up hearing about God, learning about God. Some of us grew up learning about idols. Oloku, Ebo. It's a background. Some of us came from background. My children came from background where they see their father and their mother talk about Jesus, talk about love and things like that. But I came from a background that was complicated for many reasons. Am I communicating here? I had to fight to break away from that background. I came from a polygamous background. That's the first one. So you see, background matters. On the other hand, my wife came from a different background. She was born and brought up in Lagos. I was born and brought up in the village, in Isha. In my father's house. I have time. I have a few minutes to say this. In my father's house, because there are so many children, plenty. I'm the first born among 20 something children. You are shouting. Some of you, your own is more than my own now. Well, about 21 or 22. But some of you, your own is more than my own. Praise the Lord. Am I communicating now? So my father built a compound, a family compound. You know, you build house like a dormitory. You build like this, like this, like this, like this. So we have an open space in the compound. So you have children here, and you will see in the morning, my father loves noise. He was a happy man. He would put on music very loud, and everybody will be making noise. He likes to shout. Somebody will be shouting from here and shouting to there. So I grew up from a shouting background. So when I married, my wife, my background was just contrary to my wife's background. So when I'm talking to my wife will just recline. I say, why are you shouting at me? Then I say, but who is shouting at you now? You always say, I'm shouting at you. Am I shouting at you? Who is shouting at you now? I'm talking to you, say I'm shouting.
Because that's how we talk in my father's house. I didn't know I was shouting for a long time. Until some time later, and I discovered that, oh, so this is not how it is in other places. So I was actually shouting. Am I communicating here? What she called shout to me was normal. Background matters. Background matters. Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus. By potential, he's an honorable man. But by reason of the history of his background, he has collected some unclean things. But he will not take, he will not remain like that. Am I communicating here? Somebody say, thank God for Jesus. Say it again. Say it again. It doesn't matter the background with which you were born. Jesus Christ has rectified every faulty foundation in your life and your family. Lift your voice and shout a big amen. Amen. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. All things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. From now on, you are a new species. So we can close on time. Back to the story of blind Bartimaeus. Because there was this desire from within him that I must not remain like this. You see, let me tell you what. See, your choice creates opportunity for you. When you make the right choice, it opens a positive door for you. When you make the negative, when you have negative choices, it will open for you negative opportunities. Negative doors. But your world revolves around the choice or choices you make. You must learn to take responsibility for your life. Bartimaeus was no longer worried about his background. Some people like to blame their father and mother. If my father was not this, I would have been better than this. If my father had done this, I would have been better than this. No. You've gone beyond that. You've gone beyond that. Take responsibility. From now on, there's nothing wrong with me that cannot be corrected. Am I communicating here? From now on, there's nothing wrong with my family that cannot be corrected. There's nothing wrong with my business that cannot be corrected. There's nothing wrong with my ministry that cannot be corrected. I take responsibility. Somebody say, I take responsibility. That's what faith does for you. Faith puts you in charge. I'm enjoying this altar. I said, faith puts you in charge. The just shall live. You got it wrong. I know. You are on the same page. No, if you just end it by, if you say the just shall live by faith, people will not understand what you are saying, because it could be your pastor's faith. But the Bible said the just shall live by his faith. Someone say, my faith. My faith. My faith. We do it. Oh, say it again. Say, my faith.
My faith.
We do it. My faith.
We do it.
My faith, we do it. It does not matter how I was born. That's why I keep saying you are in charge. Faith puts you in charge. Fear puts the enemy in. I say that again. Faith puts you in charge. Fear puts the enemy in charge. So it got to a point, I can't remain like this. And because there was this desire to live a better life, this desire to break away from that useless foundation, this desire to return to his father all those negative inheritance, Jesus was passing by. He heard some noise. He said, come, please. What is that noise for? I'm hearing some noise on the highway. What's going on? He said, it's Jesus that is passing by. He said, Jesus, the son of David. So
as they were getting closer, he began to scream, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me, Jesus, thou son of David. It was embarrassing. Embarrassing. Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me, Jesus. The thing was disturbing everybody. So all those protocol guys, somebody say protocol. Oh, he bless you, don't get protocol for here. Say protocol. Those protocol guys with their suits, with all those, you know, he say, hey, you are disturbing us. You are disturbing the master. Keep quiet. He said, who are you? He said, we are the bodyguards. We are the protocol. We are Mopo. Keep quiet. He said, ah, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. The more they try to shut him down, the more he opened his mouth. Tonight, when you raise your voice, God will hear you. Heaven will respond to you. Jesus will respond to you. Somebody say, I raise my voice. 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 And no devil can stop me. Jesus is in the house. Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And the Bible says, Jesus stood still. Who told you are not important? Who told you that God does not know your name? Who told you that God will not look at your case? Who told you that God will not have mercy on you? Who told you that God has no time for you? As I'm talking right now, heaven is attending to your case. As I'm talking right now, heaven is attending to your case. As I'm talking right now, heaven is attending to your case. I say heaven is attending to your case. I say heaven is attending to your case. Heaven is attending to your case. Lift your voice and shout three times, amen. Come on. Jesus stood still. Then he told the guys, those heavy bodyguards, those protocol guys, he said, go and call him for me. All those that used to obstruct you, they are the very agents and messengers God will use to bring good news to you. They are the ones God will use to deliver your package of promotion to you. They are the ones that God will use to deliver your package of promotion to you. They are the ones God will use to deliver your package of promotion to you. They are the ones God will use to deliver your package of promotion to you. They are the ones God will use to deliver your package of promotion to you. Lift your voice and shout the thunderous amen. Go call him. So when they got there, they said, be of good comfort. Stretch your hands towards me. Receive comfort. 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 In the name of Jesus. God sent him to go and call him. They became prophets. Be of good comfort. He called thee. Am I communicating? These big guys who were blocking the road suddenly became the ones that opened the door. They got out of the way and said, pass. He called thee. They thought Jesus only attends to big men. But they talk Jesus only attends to those on the mountain top. But the Bible tells me that God is not only the God of the mountain, he's also the God of the valley. So it does not matter where you are right now, God is going to visit you. 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 Lift your voice and shout a big amen. And suddenly, when he heard it, you mean he called me? He said, wait a minute. He took off his beggar's garment and threw it away. Please wait. This is the sweetest part. I feel I run in here. This is the sweetest part. Make I run. I won't run yet. But wait. This is the sweetest part, Bishop. They said he called you. And this man took away his beggar's garment. How do you know that you will not need that beggar's garment again? Wait, please wait. He has not yet reached where Jesus is. He only heard that Jesus is calling you. And the man took away his garment, his beggar's garment, and threw it away. In other words, he was saying, there is no bye-bye to what? Begging and poverty. There is no way I can, there is no way I will encounter Jesus and remain the same. Oh! 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 I can't meet Jesus and return with this garment. I can't meet Jesus and come back here to be begging again. I can't meet Jesus and remain in poverty. I can't meet Jesus and remain in pain and sickness. I can't meet Jesus and remain the same. I'm closing now. That's what the Bible calls faith. Throw away that garment. Even though you have not met him. Just the fact that he said to you, come, is enough. One word from Jesus is enough for me. I said, one word from Jesus is enough for me. I said, one word from Jesus is enough for me. That's what they call faith. And when Jesus saw the faith, even if Jesus didn't plan to heal him, he must heal him. The man said, I cannot remain a beggar anymore. He threw it away. What are you wearing that does not belong to you? What are you wearing that does not fit your destiny? What are you wearing that does not fit God's plan for your life? What are you wearing that the enemy has put on your life? What are you wearing that is not consistent with the plan and purpose of God for your life? What are you wearing that is not in line with God's plan for you? What are you wearing? As you lift your hands in a few minutes to begin to pray, that garment shall be taken away from you. Any garment you are wearing that does not belong to you, any garment you are wearing that is not of God, any garment that is evil, any garment that is not from Jesus, let the fire of the Holy Ghost burn it to ashes. Open your mouth and begin to pray right now. I refuse to remain the way I used to be. Open your mouth and pray. Pray like a warrior, church. Pray. Pray like a warrior. Pray like a warrior. Pray like a warrior. Pray like a warrior. Open your mouth. Jesus has come into your life.
You are not permitted to wear any evil garment. You will not inherit your father's devils. You will not inherit your mother's devils. Now that Jesus has come into your life, you are not permitted to wear any evil garment. You are not permitted to wear any garment that is not from Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Open your mouth and pray. Rebogoto yakapa katuskundo rekete begede rabakata egreke tusku brigande rekesanta rapapa pakata regegegegegegegegegegegegege ah your foundation will no longer hinder you. Your father's house will not limit you. Your mother's house will not limit you. Whatever is wrong with your father's house will not affect you, will not afflict your destiny. You are marching forward. You are going forward. You will fulfill your divine destiny. You will fulfill God's plan and purpose for your life. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh my God, the power of God is in the house. Pray like a warrior. Jesus, in the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray.
Stretch your hands towards me, everybody. What a night. What a night. I'm just going to pray over you. Now listen. Once you have encounter with Christ, every negative background, whether it's in your village or city, becomes irrelevant. Am I communicating here now? Always release your faith towards Christ. Your faith in Christ is what matters. It will break anything. It will change anything. So I'm going to pray for you. Stretch your hands towards me. Say, Lord Jesus, anything in my background, anything in my background that is not consistent with your plan and purpose for me, right now. Let the power of the Holy Ghost destroy now. Now. Now pray. Pray over that. Pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Stretch your hands towards me. Now, from this day forward, anything in your background, whether it's your father's house, your mother's house, your grandfather, or whatever it is, that for whatever reason entered into your life through the bloodline, anything unclean that hinders your potential, that will not allow you to maximize your capacity in Christ Jesus, whatever it is that stands on your way, by reason of the finished work of Christ, by reason of the blood of Jesus, I declare they are taken away from you. 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 Any condition that you are forced into by reason of your background, any unclean condition, any evil condition, any wrong condition, any form of affliction that you were forced into by reason of the family you were born into or the background you came from, right now receive divine correction. 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 You will not inherit your father's demons. You will not inherit your father's devils. You will not inherit your mother's devils. You will not inherit any evil in your family tree. You will not inherit any evil in your family tree. You will not inherit any evil in your family tree. You will not inherit any evil in your family tree. You will not inherit any evil in your family tree. In the name of Jesus, victory is yours. Victory is yours. Victory is yours. Victory is yours. Your faith will make a way for you. 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 Now put those hands together for Jesus, everybody. Keep clapping for Jesus. Keep clapping for Jesus. Celebrate victory. Celebrate victory. Celebrate victory. The devil is in trouble.